So here we are at PCBC, and you run into a lot of interesting products, a lot of green products, a lot of environmental products, and of course, tons of building products. I'm with John from Burrell Roofing, and you guys have something really off the track. Somebody came up to me and said that you had smog-eating tile. Tell me about this.
That's quite correct, we do. Actually, it's called Burrell Pure. The technology is that we have a photocatalyst in the surface of the tile that can help reduce smog.
Literally.
Literally can do that, yes. And I need, first of all, maybe to explain how smog is formed.
Right.
It's a combination of nitrogen oxides, which are produced from tailpipes of cars, mm-hmm. and volatile organic compounds, VOCs. People know, I think, probably about VOCs. Well, those two elements combine together with heat and sunlight to form photochemical smog. So what we do with the titanium dioxide in the surface of the tile, which is a photocatalyst, mm-hmm. is we're able to oxidize the nitrogen oxides. Mm-hmm. So that means there's less available to combine with the VOCs to make smog.
So is it is the smog particles, or the particles in the that causes that brown stuff in the air, is it clinging to the tile and the tile is neutralizing it, or what's the components?
Well, the way it works is that the titanium dioxide is a fine crystalline form with a high surface area. Uh-huh. So as the wind washes across the surface of the tile, it actually oxidizes the nitrogen oxides as they pass by.
Mm-hmm.
So that helps to actually make that reduction in smog.
So this is like a big catalytic converter on your roof.
Absolutely, that's perfect. That's a really good way of looking at it, because we're all used to having catalytic converters in our exhaust now.
Uh-huh.
If we put these catalytic converters on the roof, we'd have cleaner air.
We'd have the problem solved.
Absolutely.
Right.
Yeah.
From both ends, literally.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, because I mean, an awful lot of the effort is going into reducing emissions.
Uh-huh.
But here's another way to do it, that once you have this problem, and we know that it's very difficult to actually get the air quality to the level that we want, then we can actually start to clean the air.
Right.
Yeah.
Wow. And from a cost standpoint, tell me about that.
Well, we have to use some expensive materials in the surface in order to be able to get this capability.
Mm-hmm.
And that does actually raise the cost of the product by about 25%.
Well, very similar to a catalytic converter. If you want clean air, somebody's got to pay for it somewhere.
That's right. Exactly it, yes. And of course, I mean, the more we have, the more effective it will be. So we're looking forward to actually getting a lot of these roofs out there.
Well, and you would think as much air as we breathe in as humans, we wouldn't mind paying for good clean air. We like good clean food and water, so why not have good clean air? And this kind of product would help us get that.
That's the way to look at it, I'm sure, yes. And you know, maybe we can get some incentives to improve. Maybe we can get some incentives to actually improve the economics.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll work on that too.
All right. John, thank you so much.
No problem. Good to see you.